it's not gonna be pushing the sacrum in towards the center of the pelvis, which is what you really want, so you wanna minimize the contact with the block. Anytime I ask people to do a supported fish, at least 30% of people have a block in the wrong place. People don't know where the sacrum is to begin with. So you can say, put it under your sacrum, put it under the bony plate of that, your pelvis, put it under, you know, whatever. But still, people usually wind up with a block somewhere around here. And it's gotta usually be moved down a bit. So if you're gonna ask a room full of people to do it, you've got to literally look at every single person in the entire room. So I do a lap. At least one lap. Anytime. If you're not gonna look at people, you know, after you ask them to do it, you shouldn't ask them to do it. They need supervision. People just don't know. It's behind their backs, they can't see it. They just don't know.
Feel.
So it's your job. Yeah, you gotta really make sure that it's in the right place. Yeah, these green blocks are not gonna work at all. That purple block will. Right under your sacrum. With the least amount of contact that you can have with it. This can be completely restorative.
In terms of something coming around with everything and that's all good, right? That's
good. Or you could activate your legs a little bit and push into the inner peaks.
So if you pull with a more advanced practice like all of us, you can lift off the block whenever you want to. Activating the legs. It's completely fine.
That's much more backward bend than that. In this position, it's kind of fun, I think, to go play with. I was going to do it tonight, but then I was running out of time. Bring the tops of the feet to the floor. The toes are pointing towards the armpits.
Okay.
If you're not very warmed up, you didn't take class or do much, they approach that really tentatively. See if you can pull the toes up towards the armpits. The knees are not going to reach the floor. Not very good. So the shoulders stay down. Now what this does, this is even more restorative, I think, you're more dependent on the lock. It makes the hip flexors the apex of the posture. And then releasing. Looks like you're somehow, the pelvis is going a little bit that direction.
Yeah,
it looks like that too. Maybe that's the cork.
Just
not
bending.
A bit?
Try it
again. Yeah. One spot.
Should the knees be working towards each
other? Yeah, if you were in that Virasana variation, you pull the toes up towards the armpits bit by bit, which will gradually move the knees. Again, the knees are not going to reach the floor, but they're going to
keep the shoulders on the floor.
Shoulders stay down. That's why the knees don't reach. Yeah, the shoulders want to stay there.
Okay, so commander.
There are a few assists that you can do here.